Hey everyone, welcome to a new episode of the Multiplayer RTS series. Today we will continue where we left off from part 3. In this episode I will make sure that you can only move a unit that you have selected. If you want to follow along with the series and have not started yet, check out the card that displays at the top right now to check out the playlist. First we want to have a script that handles all of the commands for the selected units. So we will create a new script under the unit folder in scripts and call it Unit Command Manager. Open up the Unit Command Manager script and remove the start and update method and go into the unit movement script we have created in one of the previous episodes. Once the unit movement script is open, then cut and paste the private camera main camera from the movement script to the Unit Command Manager script. We want the unit command manager to receive all the input from the camera and also send through the commands when we do press the right mouse button. Then back in the unit movement script, we want to copy this time and not cut and paste. Copy the onStart authority and update method over to the unit command manager script. Once this has been copied over, rename onStart authority to start and replace public override with private. Remove client callback above the update method and remove command set run and unit animator and has authority. Click on mouse which has the red line underneath and press control and period and select using unityengine.inputSystem. Now let us add the layer mask and also add a reference to the unit selection script by going to the top and creating a new header called scripts. Then serialize field private unit selection and call it unit selection equal null. Underneath the main camera variable, we will then add serialize field private layer mask called layer mask, and this needs to equal new layer mask as this is a struct. Next to math.infinity, when checking the physics.raycast, add layer mask. So for this script to work, we want to filter through the list of selected units we have in the unit selection script. And for us to be able to do this, we will need to open up the unit selection script and then change selected units to public so that we can access it and make sure the selected units has get next to it to make sure it is a getter so that the list can't be set anywhere else. Now that we can access the list, now we want to make sure that we can move each unit with the command move we have set up in the unit movement script. Go to the unit movement script and remove the onStart authority we had before and remove has authority till set destination as we copied this over to the unit command manager already. Because of our animations and because of the fact that we called agent.setDestination in the update method before, we want to make sure that once the command has been sent from the unit command manager script, that we can also update the navmesh agent from the unit command manager script as well by making navmesh agent public. Remove serialize field and private and type in public so that we can access the agent from the unit command manager script. We then want to change command move from private to public so that it can be accessed as well by each unit that is selected. For us to do this, we want every unit to have its own unit movement script. Open up the unit script and create a new header called scripts, and then create a new serialized field of private unit movement called unit movement equal null. Then create a method that can be called from another script which gets this information. So we will create a public unit movement called get unit movement and then return unit movement, which will give out the script attached in the inspector, and we will set this up in a sec. Head back to the unit command manager and rename command move to move unit and press control and period on move unit and select generate method and then remove the agent.setDestination as we will also set this in the move unit method. Now that the method is generated, now we would like to go through the list of selected units. For this, we will create a for each loop. So delete new not implemented exception and write for each unit called unit in unitSelection.selectedUnits, then unit.getUnitMovement, which we'll call the script, .commandMove, and pass in the point. After we send through the command to move, we want to also let the agent know we are moving like before. So we will also write unit.getUnitMovement.agent.setDestination and pass in the point. Head back into Unity and click on the Unit Selection Manager in the hierarchy and add component Unit Command Manager and drag the Unit Selection script into Unit Selection slot and change this layer mask to default as well. This will change in the future as we define more layer masks for selection. Open up your prefabs folder and click on your unit prefab. Drag the unit movement script into the unit movement slot we created inside of the unit script for the unit movement script to function as a getter. Now that we got all the functionality coded, let us run and build the game. Play the game in the Unity Inspector and click Host and Client. On the running application, we can then select Client, Localhost, and spawn more than one unit in each game window. When we select from the Unity game window, we can now try and right click with no one selected and see it is not working. If we select one unit and right click above the tent, then we will see the one unit is running away. We can then select the other unit and move to the bottom and see the unit is running alone as he is the newly selected unit. We can try the same on the running game window and try right clicking first with none selected and then select one at a time and test if they move separately. Sorry for the late post this week as I've been really busy with studies and work. I also know that this video is a lot shorter than the other videos, but I will make a longer episode for this series next time for sure. Thanks for watching, and if you haven't already, make sure to like and comment and subscribe down below if you like the content I am releasing. Join the Discord channel if you want to learn more with game development and if you would like to join the community or ask for any advice. Check out all the links down below for all of the information. Source code link is also down below. Keep well and see you in the next episode. Cheers.